miss your voice, miss your smile, everything about you worth the while. Always wondering where you are. I hope you're with us, near or far. Many questions unanswered. I guess we'll never know. But now you belong to
knows the time or space. Don't cry for me.
If you give a little more than you take, and if you try to fix more than you break, if you're the kind who takes the time to help a stranger in the rain, there's a place for people like you. If you stand up for those down on their knees and lend a voice to those who cannot speak, if you shine a little light, give sight to the ones who've lost their way, there's a place for people like you. I've heard of the streets are made of gold,
hand to hold. I believe when your days down here are through, there's a place up there for people like you. If you walk around with your heart on your sleeve, and if you're trying to be the change you wanna see, if you lay down your life for love so someone could be saved, there's a place for people like you. I've heard up there the streets are made of gold, and when you get there, there's a hand to hold. Days down here or through, there's a place up there for people like you.
Thank you. We all look at each other in amazement. I said, "Shorey, didn't I tell you don't go anywhere until I get back?" She replied, "Well, sis, I only went and peeped and saw the place." As funny as it was, I was happy to see her at peace, knowing that that could be the outcome. But it was a hard pill to swallow and a bit challenging to accept for both of us. On February the 12th, Shakira wanted to give her life to God. She got on a phone call with my cousin Tasha and said the sinner's prayer and accepted the Lord as her savior. I say that to say, throughout everything that life had thrown at her for the last 6 months, Shakira didn't lose any battle because the battle wasn't hers to begin with. It was the Lord's. There is victory. He won the battle because she is now home, wrapped in his arms. No more pain, no more tears. As I say that, I want to urge everyone here to love on your loved ones. Love them dearly. Spend time with them because time is something we don't have. Spend time building and reflecting on the good memories. And most of all, I urge you to give God a chance. Trust me, you won't be disappointed. To Shakira's family, I want you to know you were her world. Shakira loved every one of you. Ma, I could stay here today and talk about all the stories she shared about you. She loved you so much. Aiden, as little as she was, I still had to take, as ill as she was, sorry, I still had to take her to get her little brother Roblox games. She always had her love for Sasha. Mom and Dad, there are no words that I can fathom to say to express the love your daughter had for you guys. I want to publicly praise you for the awesome role model you raised in a daughter. Look around this gymnasium as you can see the many, many lives she has impacted. They are all here because of the light she exuded to others and the world. To Soraya, your mom loved you unconditionally. She did everything for you. She fought hard for you. Her love for you was infinite. As a promise to her, I promise to stand by you in everything going forward, supporting you in every aspect of your life. You have a very strong support system who I know will take good care of you. I want to take this time to personally thank the BABA, the Netball Association, the UE faculty, the Darryl Jordan Secondary School, the public of Barbados, and anyone else that I may have not mentioned, whether it was a monetary donation, prayers, or even a word of encouragement. I want to share that your outpouring love and support never went unnoticed. To our support system here in Canada, Shakira wanted me to thank you publicly for your help during her last months on this earth, in particular my aunts, Sherry Pitt, Apostle Leon Chase, Shanice, and Kimar. And I want to thank all of you as well, including Tasha and Jessica, who traveled down to stand there today on my behalf. I am forever thankful. As I close off, I want everyone here to hold your favorite memory of Shakira in your mind. She wouldn't want us to be sad, but rather to be thankful to God for lending such a beautiful soul to us for the time that we had. On the behalf of the Harvey family and myself, I send sincere condolences to the family and friends of Shakira. Sis, you have fought a good fight. You have finished your course. You have kept the faith. Now go in peace, sister. I love you.
I want to give God thanks for allowing me to take this journey with Shakira for the past 6 months.
Shakira and I met back in 2000 when my cousin Jeremy introduced her to our family as his girlfriend. Shakira would come over to our house and we would talk and laugh for hours upon hours. There it began our friendship, which later blossomed into a sisterhood. She not only bonded with me, but with my entire family, and became a household name. At almost every family event, whether good or bad, she was there, always willing to lend a helping hand. She was just a phone call away, and even if she didn't get there right away, I always knew she was on the way. At the beginning of 2023, Shakira told me she wanted to come to Canada, as it has been too long since we had seen one another, and she wanted to get some much needed rest. I was so ecstatic to catch up with my bestie. I booked her flight that same day. However, that restful, fun vacation was never to happen, as in July, a few weeks before she was due to arrive, when I picked up the phone to talk to her as usual for our weekly calls, there was a difference in her tone. Straight and to the point, she blurted, "Les, the cancer is back." There was no sounds of defeat or sadness though. She was determined to beat this cancer like she did back in 2016. In August, Shakira arrived, and there it began the quest to battle cancer once again. For the next 6 months after that, Shakira fought for her life with endless appointments, hospital stays, treatment sessions, and rehabilitation therapy. I thought to myself, I got this, but boy, who was I kidding? It is not easy to watch someone you love so dearly go through unimaginable pain and agony, and I honestly believe I borrowed some of her mental willpower to get through it. As we prayed together, I often asked God for the strength in going through this journey with her, as her friend, as her sister, and a caregiver. Many days we cried together when there were no words left to say. We prayed and we toughed it out. You may think, after having a friendship for 20 plus years, we couldn't get any closer, but we did. We had many hours to bond during the long hospital stays, chemo, daycare, and the many doctor's appointments. We would chat about our very similar upbringing, religious backgrounds, and our disciplinary parents, and her close relationship with George. If you don't know who George is, let me run it by you real quick. George was Shakira's grandmother's belt that brought her back to reality real quick when she fell out of line. This explains where she got her honest, respectful, and disciplined mannerisms from. Shakira was a no-nonsense person, very straight to the point, and if her mouth didn't say it, her face surely would. Who knows, knows. To sit here and say we never locked heads would be a joke. What true friendship do you know that persons don't disagree? But if you know Shakira, you would know she isn't confrontational, she hated arguing, and would rather work to fix the problem. She would always say, okay, what is the resolution of all of this? She was very open-minded and thought of what she can do to make the situation better. I believe the S in Shakira's name stands for two things, stubborn and strong will. In the last 6 months, she displayed both. When her doctors gave their prognosis, Shakira was always determined to prove them wrong. In her daily appointments, she wasn't only proving them wrong in theory, but in the physical, as she had strength and determination to live. There is one instance where Shakira showed great strength, and it was on the 11th of February, Shakira flatlined, and the doctors fought to bring her back. When I got the call, I dressed and rallied my family and friends to go with me, expecting that when we got there, we would see her frail and weak and totally out of it. Boy, were we wrong. When we got there, Shakira was fully sitting up in the bed, smiling, and she cheerfully said, "Wait, Shorey, you wanna bring the lasagna for me? I would do a piece now." We all looked at each other in amazement. I said, "Shorey, didn't I tell you don't go anywhere until I get back?" She replied, "Well, sis, I only went and peeped and saw the place." As funny as it was, I was happy to see her at peace, knowing that that could be the outcome. But it was a hard pill to swallow and a bit challenging to accept for both of us. On February the 12th, Shakira wanted to give her life to God. She got on a phone call with my cousin Tasha and said the sinner's prayer and accepted the Lord as her savior. I say that to say, throughout everything that life had thrown at her for the last 6 months, Shakira didn't lose any battle, because the battle wasn't hers to begin with. It was the Lord's. There is victory. He won the battle, because she is now home, wrapped in his arms. No more pain, no more tears. As I say that, I want to urge everyone here to love on your loved ones. Love them dearly. Spend time with them, because time is something we don't have. Spend time building and reflecting on the good memories. And most of all, I urge you to give God a chance. Trust me, you won't be disappointed. To Shakira's family, I want you to know you were her world. Shakira loved every one of you. Ma, I could stay here today and talk about all the stories she shared about you. She loved you so much. Aiden, as little as she was, I still had to take her to get her little brother Roblox games. She always had her love for Sasha. Mom and Dad, there are no words that I can fathom to say to express the love your daughter had for you guys. I want to publicly praise you for the awesome role model you raised in a daughter. Look around this gymnasium as you can see the many, many lives she has impacted. They are all here because of the light she exuded to others and the world. To Soraya, your mom loved you unconditionally. She did everything for you. She fought hard for you. Her love for you was infinite. As a promise to her, I promise to stand by you in everything going forward, supporting you in every aspect of your life. You have a very strong support system, who I know will take good care of you. I want to take this time to personally thank the BABA, the Netball Association, the UE faculty, the Darryl Jordan Secondary School, the public of Barbados, and anyone else that I may have not mentioned, whether it was a monetary donation, prayers, or even a word of encouragement. I want to share that your outpouring love and support never went unnoticed. To our support system here in Canada, Shakira wanted me to thank you publicly for your help during her last months on this earth, in particular my aunts, Sherry Pitt, Apostle Leon Chase, Shanice, and Kimar. And I want to thank all of you as well, including Tasha and Jessica, who traveled down to stand there today on my behalf. I am forever thankful. As I close off, I want everyone here to hold your favorite memory of Shakira in your mind. She wouldn't want us to be sad, but rather to be thankful to God for lending such a beautiful soul to us for the time that we had. On the behalf of the Harvey family and myself, I send sincere condolences to the family and friends of Shakira. Sis, you have fought a good fight. You have finished your course. You have kept the faith. Now go in peace, sister. I love you.
Thank you. dearly beloved, we are gathered here today to pay our final tribute of respect to that which was mortal of our deceased loved one and friend. To you members of the family who mourn your loss, we especially offer our deep, sincere sympathy. May we share with you the comfort afforded by God's word. Do not let your hearts be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. For in my Father's house has many rooms. If it were not so, would I have told you that I am going to prepare for you a place? For I will come. For I am the resurrection, and I am the life. The one who believes in me will live even though they will die. And whoever lives by believing in me shall never die. Would you join me by bowing your heads as we open in the word of prayer? Almighty and eternal God, our heavenly Father, we have come here today with hearts of sorrow, with hearts of grief, with hearts where we feel the pain of the one we love no longer being with us. We thank you that in the midst of the valley of death, you have given a promise. In the midst of trouble, in the midst of mourning, in the midst of pain, you have given to us a present. You've given to us a promise. You've given to us a hope that we don't have to navigate this alone. You said that you are an ever-present help in a time of trouble, and so God, we ask you that you would help us to locate your presence in this time of sorrow, in this time of grief, but also in this time of reflection and of celebration of life, in this time where we recall memories and our hearts smile. I pray, God, that as each heart navigates the tapestry of life, that we would do so in honor of the one loved. And to the one said goodbye, we say goodbye. But oh, that we would do so in honor and humility to you, the one who promises to hold our hand through the waters, through the fires, through life, and through death. And so, we thank you for your peace. We thank you for your joy and for your love that passeth all understanding. This we pray in Jesus' name, amen. I greet you this morning, and on the behalf of my family and the Hope Church, I extend my deepest condolences to you, the family and friends, colleagues, co-workers, students. This morning, would you join me by turning in your pamphlets as we open in our song, Great is Thy Faithfulness. I want to invite you to sing lustily. I want to invite you to sing reflectively as we look at these words, calling into memory and to account the faithfulness I heard as a testimony at the very end. May we too be so inspired as we sing. Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father, there is no shadow of turning with Thee. Thou changest not, Thy compassions, they fail not. As Thou hast been, Thou forever will be. Great is Thy faithfulness, great is Thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All Thy hand leading, Thy hand have provided. Great is Thy faithfulness, Lord, unto Thee. Summer and winter and springtime and harvest, sun, moon, and stars in their courses above, join with all nature in manifold witness to Thy great faithfulness, mercy and love. Great is Thy faithfulness, great is Thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, Thy hands have provided. Great is Thy faithfulness, Lord, unto Thee. Pardon? Pardon for sin, and a peace that endureth. Thine own dear presence to cheer and to guide. Strength for today and bright hope for tomorrow. Blessings all mine with 10,000 beside. Great is Thy faithfulness, great is Thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, Thy hands have provided. Great is Thy faithfulness,
may our hearts recount the faithfulness of God extended to us. As in song we confess His greatness, His majesty and His faithfulness. You may have your seats at this time. I'd like to invite to read our very first scripture reading from Psalms 23 verses 1 to 4, Soraya Magna.
The reading is taken from Psalms 23, verses 1 to 4. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lay down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yet, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me, their rod and their staff, they comfort me. Here ends the reading.
Amen. His rod and his staff comforts us through the journey of life. His rod and his staff comforts us, even as we transition. Today we celebrate the life and we say goodbye to a sister. We say goodbye to a friend. We say goodbye to a colleague. But we also say hello to each other. As we look across this room, we see faces representing so many different aspects and tiers of our society. As we look across this room, we see representation of a life well lived. As we look across this room, we see representation of a life well lived. A life that left a mark, a life of influence, a life that made an impact. And that is something to celebrate. In reflecting on conversation and reflecting of listening to others, I have captured so much that Shakira lived a beautiful life. And so we will give her a beautiful goodbye. Can we agree to do that today? Can we agree to do that today? Good. So what I want to do at this time, I want to ask our first tribute in the person of Anella Michael to come and to share with us her reflection, to share with us her journey, to reflect and share with us her story of her friend, her sister.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning, Mom. Good morning, Dad. Aiden, love y'all. Shakira was more than a friend to me. Shakira had a good few sisters, including Leslie, Brianna, Katrina, myself, and some brothers like Kimar and Jesse. This tribute is to my sister. It is entitled, Sisterhood Crafted in Love and Laughter, Celebrating Shakira Shorey Presence in My Life. This tribute was written before Shakira passed away, and I had the privilege of reading it to her. And then she said, Anella, you have to read it. She wanted me to share it with everyone. In the tipsy of life, where friendships are vibrant thread woven in unexpected places, Shakira emerged as my sister from another mother. Our indwelling connection bloomed at Darrell Jordan Secondary School, where faith placed our desk, my desk next to hers. I will never forget the time she claimed 2 days through a donation, placing them side by side, declaring, that's yours. Nobody can move you from there now. Thus the beginning of a true friendship that weather the test of time and distance, or born grow deeper into something truly special during a pivotal time of my life. And anybody know Anella and Shakira? It's Soraya's Sweet Treats and Nelly's Cakes and Catering, two cake business in Barbados. I was hit with a job and I had to call in Shakira. So I was faced with the overwhelming task of an early Saturday morning wedding. When I reached out to Shakira, not only did she turn up with a helping hand, but she turned up with an overnight bag. Symbol of sisterly love that stood the unwavering from that day forth. I still vividly remember the joy that I felt when Shakira asked me to teach her to ice a full cake. And trust me, we see the result from that all to the end. We shared adventures. It was the truck or Betsy. And when Betsy Jean failed, it was Jill. That was our two vehicles. Remember, we drove from Maynard's in St. Peter to Silver Sands in Christchurch because a friend of mine named Malachi had now opened Tipsy Tequila Bristol and Bar, and we wanted to taste his delight. And we were up there that Saturday for the opening. It was crystal out back. Some of us had the luxury of hearing Shakira sing at karaoke, and if you hear that young lady sing, it will captivate your heart. She became a constant source of correction while I was doing my Erdiston training. She would proofread my work and give me some lecture about the consequences of procrastinating, because when the assignment due the next day, Shakira and myself on the bed doing assignment all 2-3 o'clock in the morning because I have to finish it on time. Now that I'm doing my bachelor's in education, her constant advice is to keep on improving yourself, sis. Work on your grades and do what you need to finish strong. Amidst the laughter that we share, Shakira thought was a tower for playful moment. I remember when Shakira came back from Chile as the manager of the basketball team. That's when we found out she wasn't doing too well. I was doing some laundry for her and I was folding the pants. And I had the pants folding and I folded the pants and then Shakira was like, Nella, I'll fold that pants and fold it again, let me see. So I opened the pants, and when I opened the pants waist was by my chest, but the legs was on the floor. And she was laughing, she was like, girl, you're so short. She always had a problem with my height. That's her problem, she tall, it ain't my fault that she tall and I short. Amidst the laughter, yet beyond those laughters and joy, she stood by my side in the profound moment of sorrows, holding my hand through the painful journey of my mom's last few months. Her unwavering support provided a cushion for the heartache that followed. As I reflect on our friendship built on shared joys, challenges extend to the lighter moments where I eagerly anticipate the years ahead full of laughter, shared adventure. Shakira, I need you to teach me PN sports at CSC level so that I can differentiate the difference between a ref and an umpire. So I can develop some hand-to-eye coordination because you always say don't have any. Here's to Shakira Shorey, a sister, a confidant,
a beacon of light in the tipsy of life. May our friendship continue to flourish, creating many more chapters of joy. Cheers to a beautiful journey as we embark on the conquest moment that awaits us. As you can see, the tribute was written for 11 persons. Rest in peace, sis. Rise in glory.
Let me say thank you to Janelle for sharing her journey, sharing her story, sharing her experience. I'm sure if we were to open the microphone to us across this room, we would hear beautiful stories of our experiences with the one loved. I'm sure if we were to open this microphone, we would hear some humorous stories. You may hear some serious stories. As I listened, I heard Janelle mention a reliable friend, Shakira. As I listened, I heard her share of a teacher in and out of the classroom. As I listened to her share, I heard her communicate one who she could journey through life with, in and out of the seasons of life. What I'd like to do at this time is invite you to stand with me as we sing our second song. The song, The Goodness of God. I invite you to turn to page 3. There we find the lyrics to this song. Would you join me? I love you, Lord. Oh, your mercy never fails me. And all my days I've been held in your hands. From the moment that I wake up till I lay my head, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. 'Cause all my life you have been faithful, and all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. I love your voice. You have led me through the fire. In darkest nights, you are close like no other. I've known you as a father, I've known you as a friend. I've lived in the goodness of God. And all my life you have been faithful, and all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. The bridge says, your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. With my life laid down, I surrender now, I give you everything. 'Cause your goodness is running after, it's running after me. And all my life you have been faithful. And all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. Oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. Last night. Well, I will sing of the goodness of God. Amen. We will sing of your goodness. At this time, I'd like to invite Brianna Donovan to come to share our second Bible reading taken from the book of John, chapter 14, verses 1 through 6.
Good morning. I didn't find out until yesterday that I had to do this, but I had to share with you that whenever I would come home, Shakira would say, "What's the plan?" And I would tell her the plan. So I guess this was a part of her plan. And she would respond that easy. Today's scripture reading is taken from John 14, verses 1 to 6. Let your heart not be troubled. You believe in God, believe in me also. In my Father's house, there are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself. That where I am, there you will be also. And where I go, and the way you know. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going, and how can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. This is the word of God.
You may have your seats.
Thank you so much, Brianna. At this time, I'd like to ask the students from the Darren Jones Secondary School to make their way to their instruments. We're going to have a special from the students of the Steel Orchestra. Would you be so kind to put your hands together with them as they come?
Thank you. Students from the Darrow Jordan Secondary School's Steel Orchestra, would you stand with me one final time as we prepare ourselves for the third scripture reading read by Andrea Bellamy. This scripture is taken from 2 Timothy chapter 4. She will be reading verses 1 through to 8.
Second reading is from the second book of Timothy, chapter 4, verses 1 to 8. I charge thee, therefore, before God and the Lord Jesus Christ, who shall judge the quick and the dead at his appearing and his kingdom. Preach the word, be instant in season, out of season, reprove, rebuke, exhort, with all long-suffering and doctrine. For the time will come when we will not endure sound doctrine, but For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lusts shall they heap themselves of men's teachers, having itchy ears, and they shall turn away their ears from the truth, and shall be turned into fables. But watch thou in all things, endure afflictions, do the work of an evangelist, make full proof of thy ministry. For I am now ready to be offered, and the time of my departure is at hand. I have fought a good fight, I have finished my course, I have kept the faith. Henceforth there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, shall give me Henceforth, there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, shall give me at this day, and not to me only, but unto all of them that also love in his appearing. Here ends the reading. Shakira and I were friends for many years. She became a family stable. She was a very good friend. We went way back. I know some of her friends through her other activities, and I would like to say to everyone here present, not only Mom and Dad, Aiden and Saraya, my deepest condolences to you all, family and friends here in Barbados and overseas. Thank you.
Thank you, Andrew. You may be seated. At this time, we're going to prepare ourselves for the eulogy. I'd like to invite Tyra MacDonald and Katrina Snag to come share their experiences as they eulogize their friend, their sister.
Hello, good morning, everyone. I just want to say thank you to the Minister of Sport, Mr. Charles Griffith, for coming and paying his respects, and all the other dignitaries that are here today. Thank you very much. It means a lot, especially to the family, and I'm sure Shakira made a lasting impression on everybody that's here today. Initially, Shakira asked me to do her eulogy, and at first I was taken aback. Immediately, I told her, I'm sure I can't do it alone. I then started to think, but she was there before me. She said, the only other person I can think of is Katrina Snag. And here we are today. We would have prepared something both independently, but it would be an accurate representation of Shakira and her love for sport, her love for children, her love for everyone that she would have been associated with. And her Shakira Marquitta Janelle Shorey, born October 12, 1984, to her loving parents, Sonia Shorey Hull and Alway Hull. Shakira, and yes, Shakira, not Shakira, as some people will pronounce her name, and it's Shakira because she was special. Shakira, because she was special. Shakira started to show how special she was from an early age, demonstrating and dominating sport and academics at Belmont Primary, then went on to secondary school at St. Leonard's Girls initially, and then went over to the opening of the Lester Vaughan School. Shakira's outstanding ability in basketball and netball got her the attention of the coaches nationally, and she was called to trials, I guess like a lot of us have been. And she obviously made the team. In making the team, Shakira then gained recognition from colleges and stuff outside, and she was able to have a 4-year stint in the US at college. During that time, Shakira used that time to gather knowledge, hone skills, and learn new techniques to bring back home to become the best version of Shakira. Shakira returned home and then went straight into teaching and did a short stint at a primary school, and then started coaching in the PE section at the St. Michael's School, where she would have coached the boys to the under-19 basketball championship in the school league that year. I believe it was in 2007 or 2006 is when she first started teaching. After that, she had a short stint at Graydon City School, and then afterwards, she then found her roots and settled down at the St. Lucie Secondary, now called the Dowell Jordan School. During that time, Shakira demonstrated great work ethic, a high level of professionalism, and this was adored by all of her colleagues, especially Mr. Jackman. I know Mr. Jackman as well. He was the principal there during the majority of Shakira's stay there, and he would have spoken highly of Shakira. Shakira's love for teaching and sport went beyond the classroom, and she was involved in many different local clubs and organizations locally. As a player, Shakira won many championships with Station Hill Basketball Club, the Clapham Bulls team, and St. Barnabas Netball team. Also, the Talents Track Club, Shakira is part of the Talents Track Club as well, and she served as the lone female coach at the time to help mentor the young ladies in the club, because the club was primarily made up of all male coaches. And I remember the conversation, Shakira said, she's going to be a part of this club. And we then inadvertently got Soraya also to be a part of the club. Shakira was also one of the few FIBA referees we have here in Barbados. Shakira was also Shakira was also vice president of the Barbados Referees Association and second vice president of the Barbados Amateur Basketball Association. And these were posts that Shakira held up until Shakira was still active in all the group messages. This is even if it was with Talons, if it was with Barbo, which is the Referees Association, the BABA chat, Shakira was always in part of the conversation and always ensuring that she can contribute no matter what. Remember initially they said that Shakira was special. Well, Shakira showed how special she was through her strength. Shakira's strength was impeccable. Shakira would make sure that she was able to do what she set out to do, no matter how high, the mountain, and how tall the task. Shakira's passion for her country was also demonstrated when she represented Barbados in national duty. On many occasions, and was the flag bearer on, I believe it was the Olympic parade, I believe, subject to correction. Shakira's love for family. Shakira loved her family, and she would often plan and take part in many family outings and functions to bring the family closer together and be surrounded by the ones she loved. Her mother, Sonia, her dad, Alwyn, her brother, Aidan, who she calls Chief, and affectionately so, Aunt Jennifer, Sharon, Angelica, Keisha, all persons that Shakira was very close with, her late sister, Sasha, and her late cousin, Shane Shorey, all persons Shakira loved and held very dearly to her heart. But the cornerstone of the Shorey family, Miss Judy Shorey, Shakira's grandmother. Shakira's grandmother ensured that she imprinted strong family values into Shakira from a very early age and ensured that she was very deep in faith in God. So much so that Shakira held firmly to her faith and would always say to me, even when things looked dire and the doctors were saying things like, were saying negative things, Shakira would always say, God is in control. God is in control. And he is the one who's going to decide what my fate is, not a doctor. A teacher, a player, a referee, a coach, a manager, a vice president, ma'am, Miss Shorey, all roles and names. All roles and names that gained her ultimate respect in her field. However, nothing gave Shakira more joy than being called mommy. Shakira's daughter, Soraya, is a pride and joy. Shakira loves Soraya with all her heart. I mean, and is extremely proud of the young lady that she's growing into. At every opportunity, Shakira would teach Soraya something. Whether it was from her ABCs, 1, 2, 3s, or even life skills. Things that only a mother can teach. Shakira and Soraya, they started baking during COVID. Another mentioned it earlier. They opened Soraya's Sweet Treats, a business that saw them grow. It grew into what it is today, and their relationship flourished for it. They would bake many days, and sometimes they would go over and help them. We would fill many orders for Valentine's Day, Mother's Day, and all kinds of holidays, Father's Day. All of them you can name. Soraya was there with her mother baking and ensuring that they spent quality time together and making an unbreakable bond that only a mother and daughter can have. Soraya, know that mommy loves you. I will always be with you. To everyone that came today, I just want to say thank you. Thank you again. I want to speak to Shakira's friends. Leslie Ann Joseph, she was an integral part of Shakira's time, whether it was here in Barbados or in Canada where she did most of her treatment. Her friend Brianna was also very instrumental in Shakira's road to recovery initially. And I think it needs special mention here. I would also like to mention Mr. Jesse King from Talents, who was also instrumental in being a voice that Shakira can sell stuff off of. And I'm only singling out Jesse King because I can't remember the names of all the coaches from Talents, to be honest. I know there's Mr. Murray, there's Mr. Tate, and there's Mr. Edgel. Am I forgetting anybody? Because these guys were there for Shakira all the way up to when Shakira actually brought the news to them. Remember, I said she was special initially, and her strength. She was special because of her strength. Her strength was impeccable. Shakira inspired me to be stronger. In the face of every news from the doctors, where it's not good news, Shakira held firm. Never wavered from her faith. Never once. She always ensured to say, God is in control. God is in control. I believe we can all take peace in knowing that, yes, God is in control, and Shakira is now at peace. Thank you.
Morning. I knew Shakira through basketball, first as a player, and then as a referee. And you know how everyone always cussing the referees? Well, I was one cussing she too. But we became close through her romantic relationship with Terrell, as we were best friends at that time. Shorey and I became very close, like a sisterly bond. I remember when Terrell and Shakira had their disagreements, and they both came to me. If I took Shakira's side, Terrell would always say, I'm your friend, not she. But we had already formed our special bond. Shakira was that friend that kept it 100 with me. And she always came to me for my opinion because she knew I also kept it 100 with her. We played netball together in two different clubs. Shorey would always say, Kat, whatever club you play with, I did. The last club she played with was Boonerson Netball Club. And Terrell forgot to mention, we won championships with that club as well.
Apologies.
It's okay. She loved her some Erin Yearwood. Any crossfire pop-up party, she would call me up. Yeah, Kat, we going. She was the definition of a strong, hard-working, ambitious person. She can buy and sell you. Once she put her mind to doing something, you can guarantee that it will be done. And nothing shabby either. She had class. When she managed the netball senior team for their trip to Liverpool, she went all out in making sure those girls had everything. I often told her she had to slow down sometimes, but she thought she was an energizer bunny, kept going and going and going. Some nights at basketball, she would referee and have Terrell or myself helping run the stall, selling popcorns and other things. But not even COVID could slow her down. During COVID, she became a baker, selling cakes and other sweet treats. But that was just Shakira rolling with the punches. In some of our later conversations, she would always tell me, Kat, people are not nice. People wait until You are dying or dead. To give you your merit or flowers. Life is too short. So I want to implore you today to give credit where it is due. Embrace the hard workers, the strong persons too, because even the strongest persons have moments where the burdens of life seem too great. Throughout this cancer episode, she fought until she had no more fight in her. She called me 3 weeks before she passed and said, "Kat, I'm tired." So I knew from there she was preparing for the worst. And even in that moment, she wanted to put things in place for this funeral and make sure Soraya will be good. So she was working up to the day she passed. We love you, Shakira, and you are at peace now. No more hustling, no more fighting, no more pain. May you continue to rest in peace.
You see, this morning we say goodbye to a friend, to a sister, to a colleague, to a family member. But I believe that there are some hellos that this opportunity has presented to us. There is that this tragedy that saying goodbye has facilitated. You see, coming up is the Holy Week, and in my own personal reflection, a few thoughts came to mind. One of the most, or there is the most prominent time within the Christian calendar as we reflect on the suffering, the death and loss, but also the resurrection, the glory, and the ascension of Jesus Christ. And there's a particular point in this story that I have often overlooked, and I suspect many familiar with this story have also overlooked. And it's the Apostle John in John chapter 19 who particularly pays attention to this particular detail. It goes like this. When Jesus saw his mother there and the disciple whom he loved standing nearby, he said to her, "Woman, here is your son." And to the disciple he said, "Here is your mother." From that time on, this disciple took her into his home. One more time, when Jesus saw his mother there and the disciple whom he loved standing nearby, he said to her, "Woman, mother, here is your son." To the disciple, he said, "Here is your mother." And from that time on, he took her into his home. It is profound to me that in Jesus hanging on the cross, the Bible records his 7 final statements. And this third one, he shares as his life is ebbing away. He knows what his end is. He is very aware that he is about to transition. He's very aware of the grief and of the enormity of this moment that it will have on those whom he loves. Yet in that moment, Jesus sees it fit. As he is about to say goodbye, he sees it fit to facilitate an introduction. He knew that his absence, he knew that his goodbye, he knew that his imminent death would bring about pain.
He knew that his imminent death brought about responsibility. He knew that his death brought about trauma, sorrow. He knew this. And so in those last moments, he looks at his friend and he says, please take care of my mother. And he looks at his mother and says to her, I trust this man to take care of you. Jesus facilitated a hello. You see, it was the responsibility of the eldest son upon the death of a father to take care of the household. And we see Jesus in this final moment presenting for us an example of how we are to navigate, dare I say, the sting of, the pain of, the agony of a pending goodbye. And I suspect Shakira also recognized this. As I understand, she took careful thought and took careful preparation before her final goodbye, much like Jesus did. I want to share with you three things that I believe this opportunity has presented for us, because this is our final goodbye to her, but I believe that there are some hellos facilitated in this room, facilitated in this moment, facilitated in the midst of this pain that we all may feel in our heart of hearts. You see, goodbye meant hello to grief. You see, goodbye means hello to the possibility of contention. Goodbye means hello to the exposure of things we never knew. For some persons, when a goodbye comes, there is the contention of land. There's the contention of assets. There's the contention of unresolved matters. For some people, goodbye facilitates a hello to things they never knew. Lies sometimes are presented. Sometimes when goodbyes come, we have to say hello to unsettled matters. But we see Jesus, and I suspect our friend, much like the example of Jesus, saw it fit to put measures in place. That those whom she loves most, though the pain and the void, the pain and of the void of her no longer being here, could know that in her final thoughts, she was thinking of you. So I want us to explore three things I believe Jesus allows for us to take a hold of. He is moved by the pain of the bereaved. He's moved by the pain of grief and of mourning, himself having walked through that experience. But him also pointing out to us, there is an opportunity I want for you to take a hold of. And so, I believe that in his moments of the end, his goodbye, he was facilitating a hello to each other. I look across this room, as I said much earlier, and in this moment, I imagine that the opportunity for tighter bonds is before us. I look across this room, and in the midst of our goodbye, I believe and I suspect the opportunity for reconciliation and forgiveness. As we stand here in this room to give our final goodbye, our farewell, I believe that there are hellos. We're brothers and sisters, we're family members, we're colleagues, teammates, have an opportunity to be reintroduced to. I believe that there's an opportunity to be reintroduced to systems and to integrity. I believe there's an opportunity in this moment for us to say hello. Persons who have walked a journey together with our beloved. I believe the opportunity is before us to say hello as we look across this room, a reflection of the different categories and spaces where her life would have blossomed. To lean in with curiosity and look beyond what she experienced and find what is it for us to take from her story. You see, we take for granted in this grand tapestry of life the value of people. It was Miss Snag who said it, and she closed. We wait far too late to extend our gratitude. We wait far too late to extend our appreciation. And I believe Jesus in that moment was very aware of that. He said, "Woman, behold your son." I said to you, morning, look across this room and see each other. Family left behind. My heart breaks. We've been here before together. And my heart breaks to think of us having to be here again so soon. But my heart is confident that yet again the opportunity is presented for families to stand and be strengthened, to be reacquainted, dare I say, in ways and measures maybe life could not facilitate. I believe the second thing we see Jesus facilitating in the goodbye, and I believe facilitated right now for us, I believe that this goodbye facilitates a hello to our own mortality. Without a shadow of a doubt, Jesus knew he was dying. He knew that for a very long time. He shared it with his friends, that he was on his way to die. He knew that he would suffer. He knew that there was a time coming. I believe that goodbye presents with us the hellos to life, because it reminds us that our days are short. It reminds us of the psalmist who said, "Lord, teach me to number my days, that I may obtain wisdom." I believe that the goodbye of losing a loved one causes every single one of us to stop and consider that one day we too, causes us to stop and consider one day we too will transition. And I hope that the goodbye that death brings facilitates in our hearts the consciousness, the awareness that we need to maximize the moments, the minutes, the hours that we have been given. For it is appointed unto man once to die. It is appointed unto man, dare I say, once to face the reality of his end. And I pray that it causes us to say hello to our dreams again. I pray that this moment facilitates in your heart, our sister is gone, but there's a lot of life ahead of you. And I sat and I listened to the wealth of her life. She sounds like one who took life by the bow horns and was prepared to wrestle it to the ground even down to the last day. Would you be so inspired at this goodbye? Not to allow your dreams, not to allow your desires, not to allow your potential, not to allow your ambitions, not to allow the opportunities to simply stay in your heart of hearts. And in your mind of minds, not to allow the things that Almighty God has blessed you with to stay deep in the crevices of your hearts, or maybe you're willing to live in conversations. May this goodbye cause you to reflect on your own mortality. May this goodbye cause us to reflect on the possibilities before us. And may our hearts always be aware that the end is inevitable and unavoidable. But that inevitable final goodbye, may it cause us every day to reflect and to rest in the beauty of the simple things of life. May that reality cause our hearts to reflect and to rest, even in the complexities of life. I sat and I listened over these last few weeks of the presence of grit and perseverance and strength and courage, even in the face of an inevitable end. I pray that this goodbye would facilitate in our hearts, in our minds, a hello to our mortality with a perseverance and an excitement even in the face of the complexities of life. Oh, may we learn to joy in the simple things, but oh, may we still locate joy in the complexities. It is the Apostle Paul I hear saying that I know what it is to have abundance, and I know what it is to have little. And he concludes his entire life's experience as he says, I have discovered that I can endure all things. I can persevere in all things. I can survive all things through Christ who strengthens me. Finally, I believe that this goodbye and the goodbyes that we will be confronted with as we sojourn through our time here on earth, I believe that the final goodbye that facilitates a hello is the hello to God. It's a hello to God. I listened carefully to one of the tributes where our beloved sister gave great consideration to her eternity. I sat and I listened to our sister sharing in tribute, accounting for how this young lady considered that while there are those she loves that she will say goodbye to, while there may be dreams that will never be realized, she recognized that there was something far more valuable, something far more lasting. Something, somewhere, and someone who knows no end. I believe the goodbyes of death and the goodbye of our sister facilitates, well, first for her, facilitated a hello to the Supreme Being. That her goodbye, which was inevitable and maybe premature, as we consider the possibilities. I believe she had an opportunity to say hello to God while in the land of the living, but oh, I am certain because of the confession I have heard that her inevitable pending transition facilitated a hello to the supreme being of the universe, to the supreme intellect of the universe. I believe that her goodbye and her transitioning facilitated and has accomplished a hello to the one who stands and holds the universe in his hand, to the one who makes the heavens his footstool. Her goodbye facilitated a hello to the divine, to the numinous one, to the transcendent one who in his providence has revealed himself to us all in a person. And that person carries a name. And that name is Jesus the Christ, whom at our beginning of this discourse did not ignore the finality of death. So he made preparations. However, that person, Jesus Christ, in the finality of death, stood there knowing that he had the ability in his divinity to silence the enemy of death, to silence the sting of death. And I believe this day, the 23rd of March, just before Holy Week, the opportunity has been presented to us to say hello to the divine. You see, goodbye, like I said, presents us with a hello, and I believe our sister has faced a holy God. He himself has said hello to her. One songwriter says, what a day that will be when my Jesus I shall see when I look upon his face, the one who saved me by his grace. And when he takes me by the hand and leads me to the promised land, what a day. What a glorious day that will be. And so the opportunity stands for us today also, as our sister had the privilege of, before transitioning, entering a peace and a rest in her hello to God. And her imminent death facilitated the grandeur as her eyes beheld him. You too, today, presented with that opportunity. As we say goodbye to her, I pray we say hello to each other. And may brothers, maybe not in this room, but may we take fresh guard how we choose to love those we have been given. Because we don't know the day or the hour, the minute or the second. It's not a comfortable thing to say this, but death hangs at every one of our doors, and it is certain. So I pray that we learn to love those who we have in our grasp. May there be reintroductions to those we have closed doors to in our hearts and minds because of today. I also pray that we would say hello again to our dreams. Hello again to our aspirations. Hello again to the opportunities. Hello again to, and you can fill in that blank. Please don't let them live only in your mind, only in your journals, only in your strategic books, only in conversations. But may you be willing to pursue them. But above all things, may this goodbye cause us to say hello in our heart of hearts, in our mind of minds, to one who has stood at the doors of our hearts knocking, inviting us, extending an invitation to come. I pray we find peace in our hearts with him through the person of Jesus Christ. Because one day there will be a hello with or without ours here on earth. And if we have not had the privilege like our sister did, may God have mercy on our soul. And so I ask you, he stands at the door knocking, inviting you, pointing you towards each other, pointing you towards your gifts, your talents, your dreams, the possibilities, the opportunities, the exciting thing, the simple things, the complex things. Oh, but he also stands knocking, inviting you to say hello to himself. I leave you with this question. What will you do? Almighty and eternal God, we hear you. Almighty and eternal God, we pause in this moment and we reflect on our own unconscious conscience. We pause in this moment and we reflect on our own mortality. We pause in this moment and reflect on our own freedoms and responsibilities. We pause in this moment and reflect on our own offspring, our siblings, on our fathers, our mothers. We pause in this moment, God, and we reflect on all you have given us. The wise man said it's all vanity. The wise man said it's all vanity. I pray, Lord, that we would make the most of what you have given to us. But I pray, God, that we would make the most of who you are
and who you've revealed yourself to us in the person of Jesus. My prayer, Lord, is that a peace that passeth understanding would so envelope the hearts of those who lift their eyes up towards the hills, from whence cometh their strength. May their confession be, my strength cometh from the Lord. I pray, eternal God, that you would bring a sense of reassurance as the journey of grief is navigated. You would bring a sense of joy as the memories of a sister, of a friend, of a daughter fills the hearts and minds. God, it will not be an easy time coming forward. But we know that if we are able to locate your presence, your promise, that though the winds may blow, and though the seas will roar, though the elements and the complexities of life present themselves, we can be assured. That our anchor holds. That our houses will not fall. That our lives are secure. And so God, every morning heart, I pray your peace. To every grieving soul, I pray your comfort. To every turmoiled mind, I pray your clarity. Jesus' name. Amen. And amen. At this time, there's one last song for us to sing. I invite you to stand with me. And as we sing this final song, it is my prayer that you reflect on the eternal conscience, the supreme being, the divine intelligence. I humbly submit, his name is Jesus. And he is here with us. And this song points us to that reality. This song and its lyrics comfort our heart in light of that truth. So, may we reflect as we sing. The song says, hide me now under your wings. When the rise and thunders roar, I will soar with you above the storm. Father, you are king over the flood. I will be still, I know you are God. When the oceans rise, when the oceans rise and thunders, I'd like to invite the pallbearers and the family to join me. Soar with you over the storm. Father, you are king over the flood. I will be still, know you are. I will be still, know you. I'd like to do one last thing. I'd like to ask the family members just to join me here at the front. You can just make way for the family to come. I'll get back to you in one second. Just want to do one last thing. Family, would you join me here? All family members,
And I want to ask you to, if you would indulge me and each other, to embrace each other at this time as we pray. Hold the hand. Where needs be, hug and embrace. God, we, at this moment, as we transition from this ceremony, God, to the next stage of this morning's goodbye, we specifically pause to ask you, in the name of Jesus, that you would strengthen this family, God, not as their minds and their emotions or culture has suggested that they be strengthened, but by the supernatural grace that comes by believing upon you. God, I pray you would gird them up, God, and you would unify them together. I pray, Lord God, that this goodbye would facilitate a sense of forgiveness and reconciliation, God. May the Shorey family, an extension, God, would they, Father, would they blossom. God, we say goodbye, but Father, the hellos, I pray, would be rich across this room today. Right here, right now, God, I pray that they would navigate this together, allowing you to lead them. God, I pray, God, that they would not fall to the deceit that time heals all things. I pray, God, their hearts will be comforted, God, in knowing that with time things will get easier. But, oh, God, I pray that they would not fall for the cliches that we say at this time, but instead, God, they would embrace each other. I pray, God, that we wouldn't rely on quick fixes to ignore or to avoid or escape the pain, but I pray that they would embrace each other. God, I pray that there would be laughter in their houses in the midst of this pain. I pray that joy would flood their souls and minds as they reflect, even amidst the tears, God. I pray that your presence would be located. So I pray for this family in the name of Jesus, God. With the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with them. God, would you cause the light of your countenance to shine on them as they in faith look to you. God, may this goodbye facilitate the hellos that have not been said for quite some time. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen and amen. God bless you. Thank you.
miss your voice, miss your smile, everything about you worth the while. Always wondering where you are. I hope you're with us, near or far. Many questions unanswered, I guess we'll never know. But now you belong to away. I'll always remember.
No one ever knows the time or space. Don't cry for me.
Miss your smile, everything about you worth the while. Always wondering where you are. I hope you're with us, near or far. Many questions unanswered. I guess we're to tears. All the love you gave us
never knows the time or space. Don't cry for me.
Miss your smile, everything about you worth the while. Always wondering where you are. I hope you're with us, near or far. Empty without your smile. Forever and miss your smile. Everything about you worth the while. Always wondering where you are. I hope you're with us, near or far. Many questions unanswered, I guess we'll never know. But now you belong to empty without your smile.
one ever knows the time or space. Don't cry for me.
Praise be to God and Father. Praise be to the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. For it is in his great mercy he has given us new birth into a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus. For in him we have an inheritance that can never perish, can never spoil or fade. This inheritance is kept in heaven for you who through faith are shielded by God's power until the coming of the salvation that is ready to be revealed in the last time. In all of this we greatly rejoice, though now for a little while we may have to suffer grief in all kinds of trials. These trials, they come so that the proven genuineness of our faith is of greater worth than gold, which perishes even though refined by fire, may result in praise, glory, and honor when Jesus is revealed. Though you have not seen him, you have loved him, and even though you do not see him now, you believe in him and are filled with an inexpressible and glorious joy. For you are receiving the end result of your faith and the salvation of your souls. I know that my Redeemer lives and that in the end, he will stand on the earth. And after my skin has been destroyed, yet in my flesh I will see God. I myself will see him with mine own eyes, and I not another. How my heart yearns within me. For I tell you all a mystery. We will not all sleep, but we will be changed in a flash, in the twinkling of an eye, at the Lord's last trumpet. For the trumpet will sound, and the dead will be raised imperishable, and we will be changed. Then the saying that is written will be true. Death has been swallowed up in victory. O grave, therefore, where is your sting? The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God Almighty, he gives us victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my brothers and sisters, stand firm and let nothing move you. Always give yourselves fully to the work of the Lord, because you know that your labor in the Lord is not in vain. For as much as the spirit of our departed loved one has returned to God who gave it, we therefore tenderly commit her spirit, her body, to the grave in sure trust and certain hope of the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ, who shall give us new bodies like unto his glorious body. For the testimony stands so, blessed are the dead who die in the Lord. And we say, dust to dust, ashes to ashes, we commit this body in Jesus' name.
things in the past, things yet unseen, wishes and dreams that are yet to come true. And all of my hopes, all of my plans, my heart and my hands are lifted to you. Praise to you as a pleasing sacrifice. Lord, I offer you my life. Things in the past, things yet unseen, wishes and dreams that are yet come true. All of my hopes, all of my plans, my heart and my hands are lifted to you. Lord, I offer my life to you. Everything I've been through, use it for your glory. Sing my praise to you as a pleasing sacrifice. Lord, I offer you my
I invite you to turn to page 8 as we sing together the hymn, It Is Well With My Soul.
Peace, my God, in the heart and breath, my faith.
things in the past, things yet unseen, wishes and dreams that are yet to come true. And all of my hopes, all of my plans, my heart and my hands are lifted to you. Praise to you as a pleasing sacrifice. Lord, I offer you my life. Things in the past, things yet unseen, wishes and dreams that are yet come true. All of my hopes, all of my plans, my heart and my hands are lifted to you. Lord, I offer my life to you. Everything I've been through, use it for your. Praise to you as a pleasing sacrifice. Lord, I offer you my pleasing sacrifice. Lord, I offer you my life. Lord, I offer you my life.
Like to invite anyone with their flowers at this time to make their way. All remaining bouquets and flowers, we invite you to come. And so as we transition, we bring this time formally to a close, I'd like to remind you of our three thoughts. Goodbye facilitates beautiful hellos at every juncture. There is the goodbye that facilitates the hello to our own mortality. The goodbye that facilitates the hello to our dreams. The goodbye that facilitates the hello to each other. And may this goodbye facilitate our hello to God Almighty. As we close, our Heavenly Father, God Almighty, of all mercy, we look to you in this moment of sorrow and bereavement. Comfort those ones whose hearts are heavy and sad, and will you be with them? O Lord, may they love and serve you and obtain the fullness of your promise in the world to come. And now, God, I ask, may the God of peace, who through the blood of the eternal covenant brought back from the dead our Lord Jesus Christ, that great shepherd of the sheep, equip us with every good thing for doing your good work. We bless you as we remember the words of Job. Blessed be the name of the Lord, who giveth and who taketh away. My name is Reverend John Yard from the Hope Church. On the behalf of my family and congregation, I wish you all, friends and family, my deepest condolences, and may the peace of God be with you. God bless you all.
Until I lay my head, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God.
Cause all my life you have been
Thank you.